I think we're looking at it as two smaller seasons that I think will overlap with each other, but really looking at the winter finale as kind of a halfway point to the season. It's like 10 episodes in, and then and what's great is it allows us a little more time to explore and play out certain relationships and characters. We're having a lot of fun with some of the stuff that we thought would be blowing through quickly, story-wise, so we're kind of letting some of the back half take shape as it goes along. We have a plan for the year.
So how many scripts have been written at this point?
Six.
Okay. You mentioned that you guys are introducing a lot of new characters this season. Which one is personally your favorite, and why do you enjoy?
I think Toni Topaz is great because it's great to get another woman on the show with a distinct personality and point of view. I mean, I think that's one of the strongest things about Riverdale, and she is sort of a female Jughead, which is really fun, and it's also just fun to see a sort of smart, opinionated woman from the South Side.
Now, speaking about Toni, in the comics, she's typically represented as bi. Is she going to be bi on the show?
Yes, she will be.
Now, what are the challenges of having a bi character on the TV?
Well, we have bi characters. I mean, Legends of Tomorrow, which I also work on. We have bisexual characters. I think it's not so much a challenge as it is an opportunity. It's an opportunity for more different love triangles and love stories. And, you know, certainly we deal with it all of our shows, one way or another, and so I think it's fun. It just means more people for the people that crushes them.
Last episode came in with a crime. Most of the first season was sort of going through the crime. Is sort of like, you know, mysteries and sort of criminal activity a thread you'll be carrying through the second season?
Absolutely. I think that there, you know, the image that we kind of, that Roberta and I talked about from the very beginning of Riverdale was the opening of Blue Velvet, which is you see like this green grass and this white picket fence, and then you see a severed ear. And so it's always about the darkness underneath this sort of suburban fantasy, and I think that we'll continue to explore that as long as the show is on the air.
Can you guys please say your name for the sake of transcription? Asha Bronfield?
Really long.
So you're talking a little bit about how this season there'll be 22 episodes, we'll get to tell more stories. Are we going to see more of the person?
Definitely. Yeah, definitely. I think even though 22 sounds like a lot of it,
I mean, we have like such a huge cast, so I feel like it's not all the time, if you correct me if I'm wrong, Sarah, but I don't feel like writers always get to explore the new ways that they want to, because there's so many people. But hopefully in 22 episodes, you know, we'll get to see a little bit more about what's going on with the girls and our relationship to each other and what their secrets are.
Both of you guys were talking about how important it was to have that you guys are representing a diverse Pussycat Dolls group. Have you guys had any meaningful interactions with fans who are just excited to see you guys playing this iconic group?
Yeah, for sure. We have this one guy on Instagram, his name's Peyton, give him a shout out. And from the beginning, like, he has been so supportive. He's like all about rocking it, like natural hair. And what did he say to us when we reached out?
I don't know, but I've had a lot of girls say that they just like their hair. Or sorry, I feel like I particularly have hair that doesn't like curl. It's just kind of all over the place, as you can see. And I just, it is what it is. And I feel like girls that have hair like that are scared to, you know, embrace it. It's, we're God-given hair.
And that was, frankly, one of the things we loved about you and your audition. So I think for us, it's embracing what makes people and who they are as individuals.
Good. Overwhelming.
We're relatable. We're real.
Yeah.
It's not.
And I think there's like so much power in that. I feel like a lot of us, at least for me, I spent so much of my life trying to fit into this box of like, oh, like I have treatment hair, like maybe put in some extensions to kind of conform to what I think they want from me when I go into audition rooms. And I feel like a lot of my experience with Riverdale has been really just finding my own authentic power and just realizing that what I have is not only like enough, but it's amazing and like, celebrating. know, in his face like Riverdale, like
one of the hit shows. We're gonna see more of the Pussycats performance throughout the season. We saw like two or three times the first one. We're gonna see more of that.
More than that. Yeah, now they're really like sort of the in-house band. So anytime we have an event, it's like Pussycats.
So I believe we're gonna be there.
I'm curious if you guys have seen the live action of Josie and the Pussycats movie that was made.
Yeah.
I think the cinematographer was actually on the pilot too.
Is that true?
Yeah,
I'm going to double check it.
I loved it. I'm going to be honest, it got a lot of flack at first, but I loved it. And I still love it. And it was on TV and watching it always. I think it's great.
I feel like it was. I loved it. And I feel like there were like cheesy moments, but I feel like it was intentionally cheesy, but I feel like people took it as, oh, this is cheesy. But I think
it was
that
funny.
Was the point.
Yeah.
I loved it.
I thought it was great. And I feel stoked that I'm Rosario Dawson.
So, coming up with the Pussycats, can you tell us a little bit about where their story's going to go?
To be honest with you, everything's pretty under wraps, just in case one of us slips up.
Sarah, yeah.
No, there'll be stories for everyone to share.
And for all the use.
Is Val going to try to get back with Archie again?
I think Archie and Veronica is really the relationship we're exploring this year. I think it, you know, there was chemistry from the pilot on, and so, you know, the closet kiss in episode one. So that was really a slow burn. So this year we're excited to really try and get into the Archie contingent.